Hello everybody.
Good afternoon.
Martin and Sharon here.
Oh, good evening.
Well, it depends what time they're watching it, baby.
And good morning.
And good morning. Right, so what we're doing today, folks, it's been very, very hot out, baby, isn't it?
Oh.
Kitchens are always hot places, but not doing what we're going to be doing today, folks. Because today, we're bringing back one of the school dinners. Well, I say school dinners, I don't know whether they actually done it in school the way we're going to do it today. But it's a trifle, folks.
Trifle.
And it's a trifle fascinating because it's an old original recipe. Get going, baby.
Trifle is fun.
Right, so let's take a look and see what we've got in our trifle.
Some sugar, milk, double cream, trifle sponges, custard powder, sprinkles, jelly powder, and fruit cocktail.
So with regards to making our jelly, which is what we've got to do first, we're just going to use this sugar-free jelly. We got this, I think it's a pound a packet, isn't it?
Something like that, yeah.
Pound a packet. You can buy it in blocks, but with us, they're full of sugar. And we were trying to reduce the sugar in this trifle because sugar, too much sugar, is not bad for you. Especially if you're bleeding diabetic like me, baby.
He said it's not bad for you. It is bad for you.
It is bad. Is that what I said?
Yeah.
I get so confused, people. Anyway, and we're also using these trifle sponges. Now, I can't remember the last time I had a trifle with a sponge in it.
No. My mum actually didn't use these. I don't know if you remember. Swiss roll, she used to use a Swiss roll.
Or you can use a Swiss roll, same sort of thing. I like it, baby, I like it. And we're using a tin of fruit cocktail. And the ones everyone always wanted was a little blinking cherry in there. Do you remember that? Always wanted a cherry, and there's only about two or three of them in there. So we always wanted a bit with a cherry in. That's going in with the jelly. So what we're going to do first is make the jelly up. To do that, we've got to boil some hot water, haven't we, baby?
I'm going to use, because I've got a big bowl, which I will show you here, I'm going to have to use the two
and
packets.
And the big jug, ladies and gentlemen.
Two packets of this.
Get on with it,
so
baby.
Let's get Martin,
what?
Put the kettle on.
Put kettle on, mother. Let's get the kettle out. And here's one I prepared earlier, baby. Right, get your jugs out of the way, Sharon. You always got your jugs in shock. Get them away, come on. So we're using our little worktop cooker, folks.
I'm just going to come around and switch it on.
You go around. I could have turned it around. All you had to do was turn it around like that.
Come around to get a spoon anyway.
Yeah, getting a spoon. Okay, right. So we've got our hot water on with our... No, it's not hot yet, is it? We'll be hot though, won't it?
Well, hopefully, yeah.
We've got our kettle on, folks. We'll just let that boil and then we'll come straight back to you. Here's a little interlude.
When my man comes home from work, I like to give him something special. Oh, I can hear him coming. Here he comes now.
Oh, you bloody beauty. When I come home from work, I like something special. Have you got anything for me, baby?
I'm Yorkshire Tea.
Yorkshire Tea? Put kettle on, mother. Let's go and have a cup of tea. We like Yorkshire Tea. Yorkshire Tea is for us. This is what we drink. And we love it. Can I have a drop of your juice, baby? My mama's starch. Yorkshire Tea. Happy days.
Here we go again, baby. That kettle sounds like 1970s to me. Do you remember the 70s, baby?
I do.
I'd love a cup of tea, but that's another story.
Yeah, so we're going to make jelly.
Let's get on with this jelly, folks. Right, okay, baby. Turn your little boiling kettle off. So you just whack this powder in there.
There's two, I think it's actually called crystals, isn't it?
Yeah, they're jelly crystals, folks. So make your jelly. How much water are you going to put in there, baby?
I'm going to add a pint because I've got two packets there.
Right, so we're making a pint of jelly here, folks. You've probably got to do this the day before, haven't you? Or maybe later on in the evening, because this has got to set in the fridge.
Well, you've got to have a pint of boiling water for two packets, then we top up with cold.
Oh, do you?
Yeah. But for this one, because I'm using this, I'm going to put some of this juice in as well to get the flavour in the jelly.
Okay, baby. Right, so all she's doing now is just adding that juice in there. That syrup, isn't it? It's a sugar syrup, actually. So you're just adding that into our jelly. That's cold, by the way, folks.
And then we're going to top this jelly up now. So it should be up to 2 pints, but I would just do it under 2 pints.
Right, because we're going to be putting the fruit in.
Yeah.
Right, folks, so we've basically got 2 pints of jelly there, Sharon, isn't it?
Mm.
And that's coming down to temperature. Just put a bit of cold water in it. And now this is our bowl, what we're going to be making our jelly in. So she's just going to get these trifle sponges. They actually do call them trifle sponges. And they're very dry. And you're just going to lay them in and around our little bowl, baby. Is that right?
Yeah.
try and spread them out a little bit, like around the sides.
When you mix the jelly in, they dissolve anyway.
And they'll probably float, Sharon.
They won't, because they break up when you...
Right, so you're putting how many in there?
Well, I'm going to put the packet in.
Oh, go on in.
I used to like pinching these out of the cupboard when I was little.
Of course you did, Sharon.
Mm. We'll just add the fruit.
Yeah. Just plonk it in the middle. Don't forget, folks.
Oh, look, three cherries.
Oh, there's a cherries. Look, one, two, three. Hey, who's going to get the cherry, Sharon?
I don't know, because it would be hidden, wouldn't it? And now we just add...
Pour it in slowly, folks. Just pour it in slowly. All that's going to soak in. And this is going to set overnight. Oh, look at that, look. Just give it a poke about. You don't want to break them biscuits up in
you
there,
can,
folks.
You can, it doesn't matter.
Well, you don't want them to go
they
through.
They will break. With
so the... just give it a little prod. Look at that. Right, so that's going to go in the fridge, and then we'll come back to that when it's actually all set and nice and cold. Yep. So can you see, folks, how lovely and dense that jelly is now with the fruit cocktail in there and also them sponges? That's going to be lovely to cut through, and you're going to get a real substantial pudding for very little money here. Right, it's the next day now, folks, and we've had that in there overnight. So what are we going to do now, baby?
We're going to make the custard, so...
So we're going to take our pint of milk and we're going to put that in
our
saucepan.
We're not going to pour it all in. We're going to leave a little bit in the jug to...
Oh, what's that?
Make the paste.
Oh, I see. Okay, baby.
So we'll stick that on now.
Yeah. Our little cooker, baby. Look, we love these things, look.
And then while that's getting warm, 2 heaped teaspoons of custard powder.
Right. Whack it in your jug.
And 1 or 2 heaped teaspoons of sugar. We have one because we don't like things
to taste.
Sweet.
Do that to taste, baby. Yeah. You want to get your balloon whisk?
Yeah, spoon will do.
You happy with a spoon?
Yep.
Normally she likes a balloon whisk, folks. It does help, to be honest with you. Stop getting lumps, baby, doesn't it?
There is no lumps.
But there is no lumps, you're right. So I'll have to stay defeated on that one because you was right. And then what do you do?
Wait for the heat. The milk to start boiling, pour it in here, mix it in.
So you pour that into there?
Then stir it and then pour that back into there to heat to thicken up.
Right, just a bit of backwards and forwards stuff, folks. Let me go and get the jelly out. So, folks, I've just pulled that and look how that's set, look. That is a full jelly baby, isn't it? Jelly baby. Did you get it?
Oh,
I had a joke, baby.
Oh, you little jelly baby.
Look at that, lovely and soft. And I can see the two cherries now.
They're right next to each other.
So someone's going to have a double cherry, aren't they?
Oh, they've got a whammy. Double whammy.
How about that? Right, so what else have we got to do?
That's it.
We've got to make the... Whip the cream up as
can't
well,
can't make
we?
The cream yet, because you've got to wait for the custard to cool before you put the cream on.
Right.
Making trifles a waiting game.
Yeah, it is a waiting game,
but
folks.
It's not like ours. Do remember, when you make your custard and you've done all that, do not pour it on there hot.
Right, so we've even got to wait for the custard to go cold, folks.
Well, cool.
Yeah, you don't want to be pouring hot custard onto that coldly set jelly there. So.
I've done it before and it goes into the jelly.
Well, that's experience, baby, isn't it? So we'll let this boil up, folks. We'll pour it into there and then we'll put it to the side to cool down. Right, so we're just pouring that hot milk now into our custard mix. That little bit of powder, folks. Can you see how that's thickening up already? Look at that, look. How about that?
Pour it back into there. In fact, I don't think I really needed to do that this time. This is a first.
What's a first, baby?
It's gone that thick straight away.
Yeah, you can't beat this powdered custard, folks. It is blinking good. It's very tasty. And I know you can make your own with eggs and that, but this is just so simple, isn't it?
It's lovely, isn't it? I don't think I'm going to get it much thicker than that, to be honest.
No, that's thick enough. So we'll let that stand now. We'll turn that off.
I'm going to take that out of there, though, to cool it down, because it'll metal retains the heat. So get it in the jug.
Right, that custard, baby, now is cool, and it's actually thickened up a bit more, hasn't it?
Yeah.
So let's pour it on top of the custard, then. No, let's pour it on top of the trifle.
Jelly.
Jelly trifle.
Jelly and accessories.
Can you see how thick that's got now? It is like a jelly itself, baby, isn't it? So you're just going to whack that cold custard on top of that trifle. Right, now she's just going to gently spread that out, folks, minding not to get it up the glass. And you'll have quite a nice thick layer there, not too thick. Just make it all even.
That hasn't got to be perfect, it's going to be covered with cream.
No, of course it ain't got to be perfect, baby. There we go. Can you see what we're going for there, folks? Look, we just want to look around and you want to be able to see the different layers, and the top layer is going to be the fresh cream. So that's that.
I'm going to stick this in the fridge, and now we're going to start the cream.
Right, you do that, baby. Right, well, while you put that in the fridge, baby, I've just tidied up a little bit. Right, folks, here we go. So we're just pouring this pint of cream in a bowl. This is double cream, so it is nice and thick anyway, but you can do this in a processor, baby, can't you?
My hand one, the electric hand one's broken.
Yeah, you know the electric hand whisk one, baby, so we're going to have to beat away on this one.
So I'm going to have to order a new one, because I do miss it.
Sometimes it's better, baby, to change hands.
Does help, yeah.
Come here, baby, let me have a go, I'm used to this. I've nearly made it double in size, baby. You finish it off for me.
I usually make it double in size.
Spin it between your hands, baby, that's what
I
want.
No, don't like that, just feeling, don't like feeling.
Coming up now, baby, lovely. Oh, it's made you get a red flush, baby.
No, I've just actually sat in the garden talking to Tracy on the phone.
Look how that's changed here, look. Look at that, folks, it's nearly there, look. Oh, look at that.
You know what, I'm not going to go no further. That's it.
Because it will turn all of a sudden, won't it?
Yeah, and it does.
Look at that, stiff peach, Sharon, look.
It will still get thick in the fridge.
Look, folks, stiff peach, look. Lovely.
You can't go too far, so be warned.
They say there's a test for that, and they put it above your head.
That's my name.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Well, can we try it?
Oh,
I took a chance there, baby, didn't I?
I would have laughed. I would have been quite annoyed, so I had to go back down and get some more.
Unbelievable. Right,
let's get a spoon to put it on with.
Right, so let's have a go. Cool, that's thickened up lovely, folks. Look at that. In fact, it's probably thicker than the custard. So I want to be a bit careful here, shall
I? Yeah, I just usually go all around the bowl.
Around the edge?
Yeah, spread it all about. Don't do too big a dollop, see?
Alright, okay.
This is what we always have Christmas Day, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a speciality dish this year.
We don't like Christmas pudding, really.
Yeah, a lot of people don't like Christmas pudding, but we do make it on special occasions, a trifle. And this special occasion is you lot. So we're doing it for you, special occasion. Let me go
He's
around the
telling
edge.
Me something I don't already know, people.
No, well, I'm just trying to encourage it around the sides here without squashing everything, you know?
He's got it around the edge, people.
No, no.
Oh, look.
I won't finish that.
Zoom in on that, look.
Yeah, I ain't done too bad there, Sharon.
No, you've done very well.
What is that, look?
And there's a treat for you.
Oh, I know.
Sprinkle the sprinkles, baby.
There you go. Right, let's put that there for a minute. What you can do, Sharon.
Yeah, you do the old chef's trick round the edge.
Well, it's not a chef's trick, it's my trick, actually.
Oh, well, I do it enough.
Do you?
Everyone does it.
Right, okay. Let's have a go.
As you said earlier, it is presentation.
There we go. Look at that, look. I'm just making it a little bit better. Just the edge, baby. Just round the edge. And then pull it up. Then go back in again.
And then lick the cloth.
No, don't lick the cloth, Sharon. Right, I'm quite happy with it.
Right, now get your sprinkles.
Right, look, baby. You've got to have the little shards, folks, the little shards.
At Christmas when I was little, Mum always used to get the silver balls. I don't know, can you still? I don't know if
you can get the silver balls, Sharon.
You could have put fruit on the top.
You could have cherries on there. You could have strawberries on there. And I think that's going to do it, baby.
Put what you like on it because it's your trifle at the end of the day. And enjoy.
There you go. Let's have a closer look at it. Oh, right, come on in, baby. Get a bit out. Let's see if we can get a bit of everything on there, folks. Look at this, look.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh, just finger that off, Sharon. Finger it off. Oh, look at that, folks. Let's have a closer look at it. Right, folks. Let's give this a go. You go first, baby. Tell me what you think of that. You got a bit of sponge in there?
Yeah, I've got everything.
Oh, look. Oh, it's cool as well, isn't it? Can I have a go, baby?
I thought you was having that one.
Not on camera, but that'd be rude. That'd be rude, folks. Oh, get a bit of that sponge. Look at that sponge. Look, cutting a bit of that topping off. And I want a bit of fruit cocktail, shower. I can't see a
cherry. Oh, my God, I've just seen the cherry.
I've just seen the cherry too, baby. Wait. I'm going to take that cherry as well, look. Right, okay. It's only a little spoonful, folks, but it's going into a big gate. Ready? Come on, open up, folks. Open up. Oh. Yum.
Yeah?
I didn't even have to chew it. It just slid down like an oyster.
Oh, you didn't get the crunches off the sprinkles.
Oh, I've got that shower, but I'll just let it go. Let's have another go.
Let it go. Why is the old-fashioned things the best?
I'll tell you what. We've had them little trifles in the packets you get in shops.
No good.
Adding that sponge to it takes you straight back to the 1970s, Sharon.
Or you could just have plain jelly if you don't want to put the stuff in the bottom.
Do you know what it does to the jelly? It firms it up. Have you ever tried the old jelly on a little spoon, folks? And it falls off all over the place. That sponge acts like a reinforcement. So you ain't worried, look, ain't worried about it falling off. Look, it's not wobbling all over the place. It's ideal for kids then.
What's your best bit? I think mine's the custard.
Shall I have to have everything on there. No one part of it is good. It's all good.
I do like the custard. Put it
on me. Hold me up again. Oh, I've got the crunch from them sprinkles.
That's good, that though.
Oh, what a fantastic thing, folks. Not for every day.
No.
Treat it as a once a month treat. Get yourself a trifle. No, don't get yourself a trifle. Get yourself making a trifle like we've done here. And I think if I remember rightly, back in the old days, in the 60s and the early 70s, they used to put a drop of sherry in it, Sharon.
Yeah, sherry trifle, yeah.
Yeah, I've never tried that.
I haven't.
Well, I want to say I never tried it, not as an adult. This is ideal, though. Oh, that sprinkle got stuck in my throat, baby. Well, thank you very much, folks. Hope you've enjoyed this little one, and I'm going to thoroughly enjoy this.
Nice and in this hot weather.
Oh, yeah, Sharon. Put it in the kitchen fridge.
Oh, my little Frank's going to like this. He's going to try this. This is his first bit of trifle today.
And have we got enough for little baby Frank, Sharon? Is there enough there for him?
Likely.
Anyway, thanks very much, folks. Don't forget, check out our other food videos and also our weekly vlog where we do a vlog on a Sunday. Basically, stuff what we get up to in our lifestyle as well as what we do in here for you.
Yes.
And you can meet us in the chat room every Sunday night where we're in the chat as well. So we play our video and then down the side is the chat. That chat is the live box which you can actually
speak
to.
We usually follow on from Premier Man.
Of course we do. I can't stop talking and eating at the same time, so it's rude, isn't it? So I'm going to stop talking and carry on eating. Thank you very much, folks. We'll see you in the next video. And until then,
bye-bye.
Bye for now. Oh, what crunchy again.
I'm going to put it in the fridge. Put it away from you.
Put it away quick, baby. It might disappear. Because after you've had sweet, you can't go back to savoury, you know?
So you don't want your dinner?
Oh, I want my dinner. Because they're special as well. See you later, folks.